We want to find dy dx given y equals the quantity 8x minus 5 e to the power of x raised to the fourth power. And we also want to find dy dx given y equals the cube root of the quantity 3 e to the power of x minus 2x to the fifth. So going back to our first example, the first thing we should recognize is that the given function is a composite function, and therefore we have to apply the chain rule to find the derivative. This is a composite function because we have an inner function, which in this case would be 8x minus 5 e to the x, and we have an outer function that raises the base to the fourth power. So again, the key to applying the chain rule is to identify the inner function and let u be equal to the inner function. Notice here, if we let u equal 8x minus 5 times e to the power of x, this can now be written as y equals u to the fourth. Before we do that though, let's also find u prime or du dx, since we'll need that when applying the chain rule. So u prime would be equal to the derivative of 8x would just be 8 minus 5 times the derivative of e to the x, which would just be e to the x. Looking at our formula here, notice how this does have the chain rule built in, but in our case, u would be equal to x, which means u prime would be equal to 1, meaning the chain rule is not required. So we just have minus 5 e to the power of x. Again, so we can now write the given function as y equals u to the fourth. So now applying the extended power rule, or general power rule given here, dy dx, or y prime, would be 4 times u to the power of 3 times u prime. And now we'll substitute u and u prime to find our derivative function in terms of x. We have dy dx equals 4 times u to the third, which would be 8x, minus 5 e to the power of x to the third power, times u prime, which would just be 8 minus 5 e to the x. This would be our derivative function. After doing several of these types of problems, you may be able to go straight from the function to the derivative function, but I think when first learning the chain rule, it's helpful to write it in terms of u, find the derivative, and then perform substitution for u and u prime. Let's take a look at our second example. Before we apply the extended power rule, we do want to rewrite the radical as a rational exponent. To do this, we need to recognize that we can write this as y equals the cube root of the quantity 3 e to the power of x minus 2x to the fifth. This would be raised to the first power, and therefore this is equivalent to y equals the quantity 3 e to the x minus 2x to the fifth raised to the 1/3 power. For the rational exponent, the exponent here is the numerator and the index is the denominator. And again, we have a composite function where the inner function would be 3 e to the x minus 2x to the fifth, so that's u. So again, we have u equals 3 e to the x minus 2x to the fifth. Therefore, du dx, or u prime, would be 3 times the derivative of e to the x, which is just e to the x, so we have 3 e to the x, and here we'd have minus 10 x to the fourth. So now we can write the function as y equals u raised to the power of 1/3, which means dy dx will be equal to, we'll have 1/3 times u to the power of 1/3 minus 1, that would be negative 2/3. Times u prime. And now performing substitution for u and u prime, we'd have dy dx equals 1/3 times u to the negative 2/3, which would be 3 e to the x minus 2x to the fifth to the negative 2/3 times u prime, which would be 3 e to the x minus 10 x to the fourth. While this is our derivative function, let's also write this using positive exponents. If we move this base here to the denominator, it'll change the sign of the exponent. So we could also write this as dy dx equals, the numerator would be 3 e to the x minus 10x to the fourth divided by, we still have a 3 in the denominator here, and we're going to move this base to the denominator. It's going to be 3 e to the x minus 2x to the fifth, but this would be raised to the positive 2/3 power. More than likely, we can leave the derivative function in one of these two forms here. But since we do have a rational exponent here, we could write this in radical form. So let's finish by showing how to do that. The numerator is going to stay the same. And now for the denominator, we'd have a 3. And then because the denominator here is a 3, we'd have a cube root. Our base is 3 e to the x minus 2x to the fifth. And this base would be raised to the second power because the numerator of the exponent is 2. So all three of these functions are equivalent. More than likely, you'll be allowed to leave the derivative function in one of these two forms. I hope you found this helpful.